إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, مثلك لا يخرج ولا يخرج يا أبا بكر. Someone like you, Abu Bakr, should not leave town, nor he should leave, nor should he be expelled by others or forced to leave. A statement that was said by a non-Muslim to a Muslim. And the criteria for his statement was the character of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, his manners. أخرج البخاري في صحيحه, Imam al-Bukhari in his Sahih compiled حديث ابن شهاب الزهري عن عروة بن الزبير عن عائشة رضي الله عنها أم المؤمنين. عائشة, the mother of the believers, she said, والحديث في صحيح البخاري, لم أعقل أبواي إلا وهما يدينان الدين. I always seen my family Muslims. Since I started reasoning, I always seen them Muslims. I did not see any of them as disbelievers. وَكَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَأْتِينَا كُلَّ يَوْمٍ. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم used to come and visit us every day twice, طرفي النهار, بكرة, in the morning, وعشية. فَلَمَّا اشْتَدَّ الْإِيذَاءُ بِالْمُسْلِمِينَ. And when the afflictions and the calamities and the non-Muslims in Mecca started oppressing and punishing the Muslims for being Muslims, أَذِنَ لَهُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ بِالْهِجْرَةِ إِلَى الْحَبَشَةِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam given them a permission to migrate to Abyssinia. قَالَ إِنَّ فِيهَا رَجُلٌ صَالِحٌ. In that land, Abyssinia, which is Ethiopia now, there is a righteous man there, Christian, and he will, following his deen, Christian following the origin of the message of Jesus, of Isa alayhi salam, quote unquote, he will protect you. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, رضي الله عنه, decided to migrate to. He left Mecca and he got himself out, and he's about to get on a ship to Abyssinia. فَرَآهُ رَجُلٌ عِنْدَ بَرْكِ الْغَمَادِ. A man met him in a place called Bark al-Ghamad. The man's name is Ibn al-Dighanah, Ibn al-Dughunnah, Ibn al-Dighinnah. هكذا ضبطت. وهو كافر. He's a non-Muslim. وهو سيد القارة. القارة is like a country now, a tribe. وهم من الأحابيش. They are Abyssinians too. وكانوا أرمى القبائل. They used to be so good in archering. فسأل. The man, Ibn al-Dighanah, Ibn al-Dughunnah, asked Aba Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه, where are you going, يا Aba Bakr? He said, I'm leaving this place. I cannot worship my Lord freely. Here they are for saying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, for praying, for being Muslims. They are harming us. They are harming us for being Muslims. Here is what the kafir said to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Someone like you, Abu Bakr, should not leave. Nor he should be expelled. Why? That is the question. Why? إِنَّكَ. Here is the criteria. تَكْسِبُ الْمَعْدُومِ. A person who is afflicted by a calamity, you stand up and you go help him. وَتَصِلُ الرَّحِمِ. And you keep good relationship to your kins. وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلِّ. And someone who's so needy, money he cannot even support himself. مثلما فعل مع مصطح. You give him money, you help him. وتقري الضيف. And you're very generous to your guests. وتعين على نوائب الحق. When there is a good cause, you stand for it. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the criteria on which Abu Bakr al-Siddiq was judged. He did not say that you pray all night. He did not say you fast every day. No. Manners, character. And I'm amazed, you may have heard the news about the brother who went into the airplane, into the bathroom, and he smokes a cigarette. That billahi alayk, this is manners? في الإسلام حتى, in our religion, this is manners? لا والله. Smoking is haram in Islam. I know those smokers, come on, give. It is haram in Islam. هذا ليس برأيي. This is the view of who is more knowledgeable than me. أئمة الفقه حرموا للتدخين. Is it manners to go and do this? بالله عليك. Is this a good presentation for Islam? طب, I tell you a story. And this has happened in our community. A brother told me, the brother who is managing our website, he received that email. But here is the story behind the email. Two sisters, somewhere in a restaurant, they came out, and they had some trash in their hands. And the trash can was right there next to them. Yet, they decided to throw the trash in the ground. This is what we call here, in this community, in this society, littering. Look, someone saw this happening, non-Muslim. You know what he did? He got in his car and he followed them. And of course, they came to the masjid. Alhamdulillah, he took their license plates, the number, and he went back home and he wrote us an email. Here is, if we want to call people to Islam, number one, I really believe that when the scholars define the word khuluq, قالوا ملكة. Khuluq means ملكة. What is ملكة? By inclination. You should just do what is right. We should not be acting good manners to call people to Islam. It should be a trait, something within you, something encrypted in your character, not something that you act up. But even for that sake, we should not do it. A day like Friday, why did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prescribe for us ghusl? Ghusl al-jum'ah hada. بعض العلماء قالوا أنه فرض. يعني عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه sees it mandatory. Why taking a shower on a Friday before coming to the masjid? Because of the feelings of your brothers around you. Manner. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is so important for you, number one, to realize that you're here in this part of the world not for the dunya, akhi. Not for the dunya. I assure you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not bring you from all over, you name it, to America to have a nice car, or to have a nice house, or to have a nice bank account. What is the difference between you and your brother back home who is having a hard way living? What is the difference? What? You think Allah loves you more than him? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you that Allah gives the dunya to someone who loves, whom he loves, and someone whom he does not love. Being given the resources and the means of this world is not a sign of preference by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot judge. You cannot judge it in this way. You came here in order to present Islam. When the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day, a long time ago, 1400 years plus, he was sitting with his companions and he was assuring them, by Allah, this deen will enter every house. Every house, Islam. هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. It is who? Allah. Allah is the one who sent his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the deen, the true deen, and that deen will be above all other deen. When the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told his companions 1400 plus years ago that this deen will reach every place, he meant in you. Yes, don't look to the person next to you, in you. You are the one who has to bring the deen here. But you know what? One thing that if you do not have, you will not be able to do it, which is manners. We received a letter a week ago from the sheriff department. Why? Because our brothers who park in the neighborhood, they do not respect the rights of the neighbors. Sometimes they block their way out. Is this his manners? Tabillahi alayk, would you like this to happen to you? What happens if that neighbor has an emergency and he has to leave? He has to come and call you from the masjid? Jibreel alayhi salam, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he kept talking to him about the neighbor. الجار نحن نعرف في اللغة إذا دخلت الألف واللام أفاد اللفظ العموم الجار the neighbor every neighbor Muslim neighbor non-Muslim neighbor ما زال جبريل يوصيني بالجار حتى ظننت أنه سيورثه. Jibreel kept talking to me about my neighbors, about the neighbors, about the neighbors, Muslims and non-Muslims. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to have a Jewish neighbor. And he used to ask his wife, did you give our Jewish neighbor what we have if they slaughter? فأخلاق يا أخوة. Manners, akhi. Manners. We are here, da'wah. Callers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you will not be recognized with your da'wah unless you have the manners. I want to share with you. من علم الناس الخلق. The one who taught mankind manners. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about him in the Quran, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You have an excellent manner, O Muhammad. Aisha radiallahu anha, والحديث في البخاري أيضا. One day she asked him, Aisha أم المؤمنين, asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, هَلْ لَقِيتَ يَوْمًا أَشَدَّ مِنْ يَوْمِ أُحُدٍ. Did you experience a more difficult day than the day of Uhud? The day of Uhud is the battle of Uhud. A battle the Muslims lost. Even so, Ibn Abbas will debate with you. Because of the disobedience of the command of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in this battle, 70 of the companions, Ridwanullahi alayhim, may Allah be pleased with the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, died, were killed. The top of the list, Hamza, Sayyid al-Shuhada, radiyallahu anhu, in this battle. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam was injured in this battle. And basically there is a rumor out there that he actually died or was killed. So here is Aisha asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam whether he has ever experienced a more difficult day than this day. قال نعم. And he started narrating يوم العقبة. When the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam died and Khadija, his wife, died. Basically he lost his internal protection and also his external protection presented in the character of his uncle Abu Talib. فهي سيكت الطائف, a neighboring place to Mecca, to basically try to get them to believe. Hopefully he will find the protection that he needs. فعرض نفسه على عبد يليل ابن عبد كلال, leader. He told him about Islam. At the end, brothers and sisters in Islam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was chased out, throwing rocks at him, children. Sayyidina Zaid ibn Haritha radiallahu anhu used to protect him with his body. Yes, he bleeded. Yet he bleeded. And he walks back for miles on his feet, akhi. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So sad. So sad. What is he calling people to do? To worship Allah alone. And not to associate someone in worship with Allah. And to do what is right. to pray, to fast, to give zakah, to help the needy, not to lie, not to cheat, not to attack somebody. He's teaching us manners. That's what he wants to spread in earth. And what is this is what he's calling them to, yet he chased out with rocks. Hazim, so sad. He walked for miles until he reached a place called Qarn al-Tha'alib. And he sat on a rock. And he sees a cloud above him, shading him. And in the cloud, Jibril, alayhi salam. Jibril, alayhi salam. And he calls upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Ya Rasulallah, لقد سمع الله قول قومك لك وقولك لهم وقولك لهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has heard what the people did to you, has seen what the people did to you, and he sent with me Malik al-Jibal, the angel who is in command of the mountains. Malik al-Jibal, the angel who's in charge of the mountains, sallama ala Rasulillah. He said, As-salamu alayka ya Rasulallah, murni atbiqu alayhim al-akhshabayn. Command me right now, I will make those two mountains crumble on those people who did this to you. You know what he said? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no. إني أرجو الله أن يخرج من أصلابهم من يعبد الله ولا يشرك به شيئا. I'm only hopeful in Allah that out of their offspring will come a generation that says لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. هذا هو نبينا. This is our messenger, أخي. This is what he told us. This is how we should be. We're not after the destruction of people. No. We want the people to believe in Allah. And we want to present this right to the people. We need to start acting responsibly. You're a Muslim. Your name reflects that you're a Muslim. Your attire, your face, you're a Muslim. Present the deen. Show the compassion of a Muslim. Show the care of a Muslim. Show that. But again, this is not an invitation to compromise what you believe. La. They ask you about adultery, haram, in all of its form. Girlfriend, boyfriend, they are dating. I don't see anybody but him, but her. Adultery. Homosexuality, haram, haram, haram. There is a difference between the two. Yeah. Mannerism plus standing for your belief. That is what it takes to bring Islam across to another person. I want to let my brothers know, and I may have repeated this before, but the people here, they reason things in a material manner. We take an example. Before any one of them buys a car, he must test drive that car. Have you ever heard about an American who drives a car without test driving it? Give me a break. And this is smart. I mean, I'm sorry, this is smart. Show me what Islam did to you before you give it to me. Show me state. You're drinking alcohol, you're lying, you're cheating, you're deceiving, you backbite, you don't have manners. So what are you giving to me? Name tag? I respect them too. I don't think they believe in name tags. They don't. You keep your name tag. Show Islam in action. This is what it takes, brothers and sisters in Islam, to do what we're supposed to do here. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. A long time ago, there was a superpower called Egypt. And they were idol worshippers. They used to commit shirk. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined for those people to hear about لا إله إلا الله, to hear about the message of Islam. And he chosen a prophet who's the son of a prophet. Who's the son of a prophet? Who's the son of a prophet? Yusuf ابن يعقوب ابن إسحاق ابن إبراهيم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a way, in a very interesting story, got him into Egypt. Like your interesting story coming to America. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about Yusuf alayhi salam, when he saw him in the heaven in the night of al-Mi'raj, كما في حديث أنس, لقد أعطي يوسف وفي رواية وأمه شطر جمال المخلوقات. So beautiful in face. He was given half of the beauty of the creations. That includes human being too. That includes others than a human being too. His father loved him. His other brothers felt jealousy. A story like yours, lottery, whatever, how you got here. Similar. A story like yours. But you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted the Egyptians to learn about Tawheed. And that's how he got Yusuf into Egypt. He arrived. His brothers threw him in a well. He was picked by a caravan. You know the story. We have it in the Quran. Beautiful story, Surah Yusuf. And then, here's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordains things. He gets purchased by a high class, Al-Aziz. He goes through fitness, through tests. Because of his beauty, the wife of the man calls him to adultery. Remember, he's someone who believes in Allah. A son of a prophet, a son of a prophet, a son of a prophet. Adultery has always been haram. Has always been haram. and has always torn into death, even in the Torah, even in the Gospel, has been always like that. We did not come up with something new. It's been always, because it destroys the community. It causes the production of children who do not have parents. And that causes the community to collapse. And Islam cares about the construction of the family. He said, no. He was called by a beautiful and prestigious woman. And later on, he was called by the other women. Women like the style of Hollywood. Wallahi, akhi, he said, did he compromise? No, he did not. He said, رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيِّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيِّ. Oh Allah, I'd rather go jail than do what they're asking me to do. And if you don't help me, I will not be able to stand against this. وَإِلَّا تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَهُنْ أَصْبُ إِلَيْهِمْ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. And if you do not remove their blood away from me, I'm afraid I'm going to be weakened and I will end up committing that heinous major sin. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivered him in jail. يَا مُخَنَّثِ الْعَزْمِ يَا مَنْ تَخَافُ السِّجْنِ. He went to jail not because he thrown a bomb or he killed somebody or he lit fire in his shoes. No. For saying no to adultery. But yet, a Muslim believes that he's a caller to Allah even in jail. Even in jail, you free, you go around freely. How many people did you call to Islam? How many people did you present Islam to so far? How many? Yusuf in jail. But you know again, and this is how I began my khutbah. Because of his manners. A character like Yusuf in jail, in the middle of inmates, crimes, killing, you name it. But yet, he showed the mannerism of a Muslim. The character of a Muslim. And brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to alert you, good character will be recognized even by the non-Muslims, because it's in the fitrah. It's in the fitrah not to lie. By instinct, lying is bad. By instinct, cheating is bad. So if you do these good things, people will recognize them. Two of the inmates, each one of them sees a dream. وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانِ. Two individuals who were jailed basically for the fact that they may have conspired to poison the king. The one who used to make the wine for the king, the butler and the baker. And each one of them saw a dream. وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانِ. One of them said, قَالَ أَحَدُهُمَا إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَعْصِرُ خَمْرًا. I have seen myself squeezing grapes again. وَقَالَ الْآخَرُ. And the other one said, وَإِنِّي أَرَانِي أَحْمِلُ فَوْقَ رَأْسِي خُبْزًا تَأْكُلُ الطَّيْرُ مِنْهُ. And I see myself in my dream, I see a vision that I'm carrying a basket of loaves of bread that birds eat of it. Here it is. نَبِّئْنَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ. Can you tell us about the interpretation of this dream? Why? إِنَّا نَرَاكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ We see you a good character, a good person. Here it is. Those who are seeking empowerment in earth. If you even seek in that dunya, Yusuf alayhi salam was empowered in earth because of the interpretation of this dream. But he did not just interpret the dream. He called to Allah. And here is how he did it. لَا يَأْتِيكُمَا طَعَامٌ تُرْزَقَانِهِ إِلَّا نَبَّأْتُكُمَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمَا By the way, I can do other things. I can tell you about the food that you're about to eat. But this is not because of me. ذَلِكُمَا مِمَّا عَلَّمَنِي رَبِّي This is what my Lord taught me. You want to be like me? You want to be like me? إِنِّي تَرَكْتُ مِلَّةَ قَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ I left the way of the people who do not believe in Allah. وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ كَافِرُونَ And those who disbelieve in the hereafter. You left their ways? What are you going to follow? وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ And I followed the way of my fathers, Ibrahim, Isaac, Jacob. We do not associate someone in worship with Allah. We do not pray in the name of the Holy Ghost, the name of the Son, the name of the Father. No, we pray in the name of Allah. Tawheed, the oneness of Allah. Aqeedah. And then after that, he told them, one of you will be spared and restored to his position, which is the butler, and the other one will be hanged. Shahid, brothers and sisters in Islam, yet in that situation, Yusuf alayhi salam still called to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but again, because of his manners, because of his character. It takes a character and believe in what you have to offer to the non-Muslims. Wallahi akhi, and with this I close, you have a syllabus that is syllable by itself. Hada deen, this religion that you believe in, hada deen. Ya akhi, I read that the budget of the Vatican, just for missionary work, more than the budget of Africa, the continent of Africa. And yet, you read in the news, yet you read in every place, Islam is the most growing religion in the whole world. Why? We don't even have a budget. We're having a hard time getting books now. Why? Fitrat Allah. Fitrah. Deenul Fitrah. Allati fatara an-nasa alayha. والله هذا قول مستشرق ويعني أكره أن أستشهد به في هذا الموضع يقول لك يا له من دين لو أن له رجال What a deen this is A non-Muslim said about Islam What a deen this is But if there are men there Men Not in the sense that you No Men People who believe in it People who believe in it People who understand it اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا ثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم بعلمك الغيب وقدرتك على الخلق أحينا ما علمت الحياة خيرا لنا وتوفنا إذا علمت الوفاة خيرا لنا اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهديين أكرم الأكرمين اللهم استعملنا ولا تستبدلنا اللهم استعملنا ولا تستبدلنا قولوا قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم واقم الصلاه الله اكبر الله اكبر اشهد ان لا